Hi guys, we are starting with the solution for day 4 from the selected problems of InfyTQ, module 1, fundamentals with Python. So in the first problem of day 1, we are provided with a program where we have to calculate the profit and loss of a transport corporation. Okay, so we are actually provided with the price of the liter per fuel, price per liter of fuel, the mileage of the bus and the price per ticket and the number of passengers who are traveling. So, and with the distance also. So using these particular values, we have to calculate whether a particular bus route is profit, is making a profit or it's making a loss. So buses run on various routes and we have to find out whether the routes are profitable or not. So we would be just writing a function that would be signifying the profit or the loss making, and if there is a loss we have to return -1, or we have to, in case of a profit, we have to return the profit it is making from the route. Okay, so let's go into our PyCharm and let's start coding. So let's create another directory as day 4. And let's create a new Python file. Let's keep it problem 18, as it's the problem 18 overall. So first, let's create a function, calculate underscore profit. Since it has been told, the three values that will remain constant are price per liter of fuel, mileage of the bus in kilometer per liter of fuel, and the price per ticket. We might not take them as in parameters of the function. Okay, we just need to take in two values, that is the distance and the number of passengers, as the parameters of the function, while whereas these three values can remain constants inside the function only. Okay, so let's just take in two parameters as distance and passengers, and the constant values are price per liter, which is 70, and mileage, which is 10, and the price, which is 80. So the mileage, which is 10, and the price per ticket, which is 80. So guys, in order to find out the profit, first we have to find out the amount that is spent. In order to find out that, we have to first use the price per liter amount, because it is the amount that is spent by the corporation. Okay, so use the price per liter, we have to find out the liters of fuel that is consumed during that particular journey. So we can find it out using the mileage, because distance divided by mileage would be giving us the liters consumed, fuel liters consumed. So fuel consumed would be distance divided by the mileage, and the amount spent would be suppose spent is equal to fuel consumed into price per liter. So we have found out the amount that is spent, and next we have to find out the amount that is earned by the corporation for that particular bus route. So that is given by the ticket price into the number of passengers. So earned would be the passengers into the price per ticket. So we have found out the spent and the earned for a particular bus route, and when we subtract that, we would be getting the profit. So profit would be equal to, obviously it would be earned minus spent, and it has told that if the profit is negative or if it is a loss, we have to return minus 1. If profit is less than 0, then return minus 1, else we have to return the profit only. Return profit. So now we have to take in two inputs from the user, that is basically the distance and the number of passengers. So let's take it from the users. D is equal to int. It would be an integer input. So int input, enter the distance. And P would be int input, enter the number of passengers. So we have taken both of the inputs from the user. Now we have to print calculate underscore profit, and we have to pass in the distance and the passengers parameters to the function. Okay, let's run our code and let's just think of some input. Let the distance of the travel be 800 and the number of passengers be suppose 50. So we would be running at a loss if the distance is 800 and the number of passengers is 50, that is minus 1. We are getting a result as minus 1. Let's dry run our code and see why we are getting minus 1. Since the distance is 800 and the mileage is 10, so the liters of fuel consumed was 80, and 80 into 70 was 560. Whereas the number of passengers are only 50 and the price per fuel is 80. So we are only price per ticket is 80. So we are only earning 400 rupees. So we are getting a net loss of 1600 rupees. 4000 rupees, and we are getting a net loss of 1600 rupees. So we are getting a minus 1 here. Let's run our code again. Enter the distance as suppose 100 and the number of passengers will be 100 as well. So here we are getting a net profit of 7,300 for one route. So this is a profit making route, and the bus corporation must definitely keep it. So that's it for the video, guys. Thanks for watching it. See you in the next one.